On January 15th, 2022, the Hunga Tonga Hunga Ha'apai volcano exploded in the nation of Tonga in what was the largest volcanic eruption of the 21st century so far. This eruption obliterated the existing island, causing a 4-kilometer-wide section of ground to drop by 750 meters or 2,460 feet. The eruption also caused numerous long-term effects, leading to unusually vivid sunsets which have the color purple due to a greatly increased level of volcanic aerosols in the atmosphere. For example, stratospheric aerosols at between 35 and 45 degrees south have tripled since the eruption. Some of my viewers closer to the equator or in the northern hemisphere even noted that sunsets as of late have become increasingly colorful. However, there is another long-term effect that this eruption will pose. Due to the highly explosive component of its December to January eruption, the Hunga Tonga Hunga Ha'apai volcano produced millions of tons of the lightweight volcanic rock known as pumice. Since pumice floats, large sections of it are now slowly drifting away from the volcano in what is known as a pumice raft. These rafts can be a hazard to ships because the material frequently gets clogged in their cooling systems, essentially blocking the engine while also damaging propellers. This is most likely what happened to the HMAS Adelaide in January, which encountered such a raft of material leading to a blackout. Generally speaking, when a submarine volcanic eruption occurs between the island chain north of New Zealand and the volcanics in and around the nation of Tonga, the pumice they produce generally ends up in the same location. Due to ocean currents, a significant quantity of pumice is heading towards the city of Townville in Queensland. While this material is unlikely to cause much of a hassle locally, between August 15th and September 15th, fragments of it will begin getting deposited in small quantities at high tide on Australian beaches. If the pumice does not wash up on local beaches, it will either head north and out to sea or hug the coastline to the south, potentially washing up on a beach as far south as Newcastle and New South Wales. When it does wash up, the material will most likely look something like this. It will be lightweight, brownish-white, with numerous holes in it called vesicles. Most fragments will be smaller than 2 centimeters wide, but pieces up to 15 centimeters wide are possible. We know that some of the pumice will end up in Australia because this is exactly what happened on several prior occasions from volcanoes in close proximity to Hunga Tonga Hunga Ha'apai. In fact, if you are in Australia right now and walking on the beach, you are likely to find pumice from 4 different eruptions. The volcanoes in question can be all found in the same volcanic arc and are as follows: Volcano F in 2001, Home Reef in 2006, the Havre Seamount in 2012, and Volcano F once again in 2019. Although it can be difficult to tell which eruption the pumice originated from, there is one way to tell the stones apart: color. Pumice from submarine volcanoes in Tonga generally has a brownish color, while the Havre Seamount produced pumice has a white to light pink color. These pieces are likely to be partially covered in seafaring organisms such as barnacles and mollusks. While a large volume of pumice was produced by the climatic eruption of Hunga Tonga on January 15th, a significant quantity of pumice was set adrift during its less explosive phase between December 20th of 2021 and January 13th of 2022. As a whole, collecting volcanic pumice on beaches is a decent method to find records of submarine volcanic eruptions that might have otherwise gone unnoticed, while also telling scientists a lot about the nature of the eruption which produced it. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Ella Harrell for supporting this channel.